Now will you notice verse 6, and they shall waste the land of Assyria with the sword, and the land of Nimrod in the entrances of it. Thus shall he deliver us from the Assyrian when he cometh into our land and when he treadeth within our borders. Now this looks ahead, as you can see, to the one who is the shepherd, the one born in Bethlehem. He came before in humility. And we need to note that it said he humbled himself. We don't do that. Sometimes other people humble us. But he humbled himself. And there was an emptying on the part of Christ. It says he emptied himself. What did he empty himself of? Not of his deity. That little baby reclining so helpless on the bosom of Mary could have spoken this universe out of existence. He's God of very God, and he's man of very man. But he limited himself, and that was a self-limitation. It's that which he took willingly. We do not limit ourselves willingly. In fact, we extend ourselves. We are aggressive. We want to win. We want to be on top. Man is self-assertive. He's self-centered. He's selfish. But this one is the shepherd. He came to Bethlehem. That wasn't a royal city. That wasn't the capital. He's born in a stable. That's no place for a king to be born. He came, though, and humbled himself. And he came that way. And he's the shepherd. He came as a shepherd to die for his sheep. Came as a shepherd today to watch over his sheep. And he's coming again as the chief shepherd. But this time in might and power and glory. Now, we have here in verse 7, as you can see, he's going to defend his own. He's going to protect them. And now in verse 7, and the remnant of Jacob, and I've already talked about the remnant before, and the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people like dew from the Lord, like the showers upon the grass that tarrieth not for man, nor waiteth for the sons of man. You see that he's going to also not only protect them, but going to be a blessing to them and bring strength to them. Listen at verse 8, and the remnant of Jacob shall be among the nations in the midst of many people, like a lion among the beasts of the forest, like a young lion among the flocks of sheep, who if he go through both treadeth down and teareth in pieces, and none can deliver. Well, Israel is certainly not that today. Israel has been in a precarious position now for many years. But God says, I'm going to make you the head of the nations, not the tail of the nations. And that's where they are today. They're at the wrong end, by the way. And now verse 9, thine hand shall be lifted up upon thine adversaries, and all thine enemies shall be cut off. Now, he's going here to give them victory over their enemies. Now he says in verse 10, and it shall come to pass in that day. Now just in case some amillennialist drop back and is applying this to something else, Micah wants you to know it's in that day. And that day looks forward to the future. And it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord, that I will cut off thy horses out of the midst of thee, and I will destroy thy chariots. I'll cut off the cities of thy land and throw down all thy strongholds. Why will he do that? Well, because they won't need these instruments of war anymore. He's bringing peace to this earth. Verse 12, and I'll cut off witchcrafts out of thine hand, and thou shalt have no more soothsayers. I wish I had time to develop that, but we'll be back that later on. And he's going to get rid of idolatry, false religion. Verse 13, thy carved images also will I cut off, and thy standing images out of the midst of thee, and thou shalt no more worship the work of thine hands. They're going to worship now the living God. And I will pluck up thine idols out of the midst of thee, so will I destroy thy cities, and I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the nations such as they have not heard. We're definitely now talking about the great tribulation period that is coming. And this is the blessing that will come to this nation under the Messiah, and then those others, and it's only the remnant, understand, and then the remnant out of the other nations of the world that turn to him. This is a very glorious chapter, as you've seen. Next time we begin with chapter 6, until then, may God richly bless you, my beloved.